You know, when I was a kid, I noticed my father had a cigar or two on his dresser in his bedroom. I wasn't in there very often, but I'd see the cigar sitting on the dresser occasionally. I never saw him smoke a cigar, but I'd see those cigars, and maybe that influenced me to start smoking cigars when I was 8 years old, as some of you know who watch my videos. And I don't recommend that for anybody else now. I wouldn't want my child doing that. I'm finishing up this little Rolly 5.5 by 46, 46 ring by 5.5 inch long cigar. And it's quite enjoyable, it's quite enjoyable. One thing I like about a smaller cigar is it doesn't, just, it isn't just like, you're not inundated with smoke and there's no problem keeping it going, And it brings to mind that, back when I was a kid, this is kind of the size cigars a lot of folks smoked, and even into adulthood, I was buying, what were those cigars called? Havana Blend cigars, which I see they're making again. I should order some up one of these days. And for a long time, I smoked those and thought they were a good cigar. I don't think they're all that are that great of a cigar, though I haven't had them for a long time. And then I started buying hand roll, premium hand roll cigars. Then that was a whole new world for me. But back in the 80s, with the cigar boom, cigars got bigger and longer and fatter and huge. And they used to, I've heard them referred to as miniature baseball bats. Oh, he's smoking a miniature baseball bat. And this little cigar here, and I say little cigar, it's actually just a cigar, but it brings to mind all those times for me, and how these days I tend to gravitate towards 60 ring cigars and 54 ring cigars, and I've been doing that for several years now, because some of the more interesting cigars were big, like Robusto Supremas and, Partagas Black and all that kind of stuff. And a lot of cigar manufacturers started making cigars in bigger, much bigger rings, and some of the interesting cigars, like Partagas Black, 54 ring cigars, things like that, and that became kind of a fad or a style or whatever you want to call it, a fashion. If you're watching the old episodes of like Magnum PI on television, and him and somebody else, wherever he steals one of Hagen's cigars, it's a cigar that's this size. It's not a giant cigar, what you may not know is that for years now, I've kind of promised myself that I would order a normal size cigar, a Churchill size cigar, six and three quarter by 48 or 49 ring cigar, which is kind of a Churchill size, and I want to do that, but I just keep ordering these big giant cigars. The last time I ordered cigars, I was going to get some of those and end up ordering some Partagas Black Pyramids, which are a 60 ring cigar, and then I ordered this last order, and all those cigars are 50. Some were 50 ring, but most are 54 ring, and the Partagas were 60 ring, which is a huge cigar. But this is a great little cigar here and a wonderful smoke. I don't think a cigar needs to be a giant ring to be a good smoke, Certainly there are times I want a cigar that size, but I would like to try, to smoke like 48 ring cigars again. It's been so long, really. So done much of that, and I don't think giant cigars are necessary. Certainly, a small cigar like this can be a wonderful smoke. It doesn't need to be, 54 ring or 56 ring. And I say all this perfectly well knowing that I'm eyeing some Puros Indios pyramids online right now. They're about $60 or $50 for 10. They're Maduro cigar there, and they're a pyramid cigar, which is nice. And I've got a choice between those, or I can buy 20 Churchill size cigars. Actually, they're like $60 for 20, and I'm still eyeing those big pyramids, and I don't know why I do that in a way. Because a big cigar is, not necessary. I mean, it's not the size of your cigar, right? It's how you use it, isn't it, ladies? Right? You don't need a big cigar. It's really satisfying to get a good satisfying smoke. Right, really? Honestly, really? You don't, do you? How did I ever get into that line? took a perfectly nice little video and turned it into something dirty and decrepit. Anyway, I guess all I'm trying to say is you don't need a big cigar to satisfy. Sometimes a medium-sized cigar would be very satisfying. And I can't even be serious about it anymore. Shame on me. Alright, folks, thanks for listening to my lunacy. It's a good little cigar. It's just a good cigar. No, it's not a good little cigar. It's just a good cigar. Alright, guys. I'll talk to you later.